It's Sarah here with the final part of my story. Trust me, you don't want to miss it. So in the last episode, I found out that Ben had betrayed me, and in doing so ruined my career. So I took the blame and left my job, but I had no idea what I was meant to do next. My ringing phone woke me up. What was going on? I drowsily reached for it, then saw tons of messages from my friends and colleagues. I skimmed through them, and to my surprise, they all included the same link. Okay, this was strange. I clicked on it and found that it was a video of Ben and Claire. I pressed play, and in it, a crying Claire admitted that she was the person who had revealed my design to Ben. And Ben said that, led on by personal reasons, he'd slandered me for being a copycat. Both of them apologized to the company and to me. I scrolled down. There were thousands of comments below their video, and most of them were negative, calling them traitors and so on. I called Claire to check on her, but her phone was off. She was probably avoiding all of the horrible comments. I hoped she was with Ben now, and they could rely on each other to get through this difficult time. After hearing that Claire was begging for his fault, Ben must have realized that he was terribly wrong, then came to her to correct everything. So, the truth was out, but I didn't feel good about this. Instead, all I felt was sad. Noah thought I was capable of betraying him, when this whole vindictive plan had been Ashley's. At that point, I saw tens of messages and missed calls from Noah, but I didn't want to answer just to hear him feeling sorry for me. It hurted me so bad. Thinking that when the incident happened, all he cared about was her demand and her family's shares in the company, and that I was nothing to him but a betrayer. My heart ached. Then suddenly there was a knock on my door. I opened it to find Noah standing there. He was panting and his shirt was damp with sweat. "What? Why are you here?" I asked. As soon as seeing me, he hugged me tightly. "What's wrong?" I asked. After some seconds, he said, "You didn't answer, so I was afraid something bad had happened. You were sad and I was so cruel and..." I just smiled at him. "See, I'm totally good." Then I asked him to come in. At least I should hide my feelings and treat him like a friend, right? We sat on the couch, and Noah kept staring at me. I joked, "Is there anything on my face?" He said seriously, "Sarah, I'm so sorry. I watched the video this morning, and it's all my fault for not believing you." I replied, "Yeah, that hurt, but you're the boss, so you did what you had to do." Without letting me finish my sentence, he continued, "No, there was no excuse for not believing you. Ben texted me last night and told me everything. He said he loved you, but you don't feel the same, and this made him act like a jerk." So now, Noah knew the truth, but for what? He had Ashley and he was marrying her. I smiled at him and said, "It's okay. It's all over. You should care about Ashley more than you thought. This might not happen if she didn't feel insecure that much about your relationship. You have Ashley, so take care of her." He was flustered and then tried to explain, "Sarah, please hear me out. I want you. I always have. I only turned you down because Ashley threatened me." So it turned out that Ashley threatened to destroy my career and make my life a misery at all cost if he dared to break up with her. "That's why I turned you down. I know she really means what she says, and I just want to keep you safe away from her. Little did I know that Ashley tried to wreck your life regardless," he said. Then he gave me a determined look and continued, "Sarah, I tried to ignore my feelings for you, to please my family once before when we were in high school, and I almost lost you again for that damn family company. But now I realize that without you, everything is meaningless. Please forgive me." I couldn't believe this was happening. Finally, we could be together, right? We'd both wasted enough time, but could it really be that simple? He could see me hesitating and immediately grabbed my hand and insisted I go with him somewhere. I asked him where, but he just smiled, patted my head, and said I'd know soon enough. I was kind of confused, but looking at his determined eyes, I knew I could trust him. As we pulled up to this impressive mansion, I realized that I'd been here before, back at the party where Ashley humiliated me. This was her family's home. I was hesitant, but he assured me it'd be okay and led me inside. There I saw Mr. Adams sitting on the couch and reading the newspaper. I turned to Noah and whispered, "What are we doing here?" He looked right into my eyes and said, "Getting you the justice you deserve." Mr. Adams heard the noise and looked back, seeing me and Noah. He was kind of surprised.
"Noah, are you here to find Ashley? She's still in her room. And is this lady..." "Yes, this is Sarah, the daughter of the fireman who saved Ashley's life."
Mr. Adams gasped in surprise, then said,
"Oh, it is you? How is your father?"
I smiled politely and said, "It's nice to meet you. My dad is fine, thanks." Then he asked me some questions about my dad and my job. He was so surprised to know that I was working in Noah's company. Then Noah said, "Mr. Adams, I have something to say."
And then he told him everything about how Ashley had teased me 5 years ago and the reason why I moved back to my previous school. Then he told him how she'd planned to ruin my career. Mr. Adams was furious. He immediately called Ashley to come downstairs. Ashley's face was priceless. When she stepped down and saw me sitting in her house, she muttered out, What are you doing here? Mr. Adams told her to sit down, then said,
Tell me what you did to Sarah, now.
She yelled back, Dad, nothing. Then she turned to me, First, you stole my fiancé, and now you're slandering me to my own father? You're such a liar. Mr. Adams angrily said,
Stop lying, Ashley. Noah told me everything, and I believe him. Sarah's father saved your life, and as a result of his injuries, he had to give up the job he loved. Yet you did this to his daughter? Why?
Ashley looked furious. It seemed that her dad had never scolded her before. She shouted, Yes, I did everything, but she betrayed me first. I thought we were friends, but she tried to steal Noah from me back at school, and she's still trying to do it now, even though she knows we're engaged. At this moment, Noah spoke out.
It's all my fault, so stop blaming Sarah. Back then, I didn't stand up for her, but I won't be that cowardly again.
Ashley held back her tears. Honestly, I felt bad for her, so I motioned Noah to stop talking. He just held my hand tight and turned to Mr. Adams, then continued,
I didn't dare to confess my feelings because I was scared that you would withdraw your shares. But now I don't want to hide my love anymore. For me, the engagement was just a business thing. I don't love Ashley. Sarah is always the one I love, and I want to cancel the wedding. No matter what you do, Mr. Adams, I'll accept it.
Mr. Adams sighed.
Sarah, on behalf of my daughter, I'm so sorry for what she did to you. Tomorrow, I'll organize a press conference to officially announce the truth to the public and vindicate you.
Then he looked at Noah and continued,
And Noah, don't worry about the company. As for me, work is work, and it doesn't relate to personal affairs.
Then he turned to Ashley.
Remember, Ashley, you can't force someone to love you because this will bring you nothing but pain and turn you into someone you don't want to be.
The next day, the press conference was held, and the room was packed with journalists. Mr. Adams officially confirmed that Ben and Claire's confession video was true, and I was innocent. He also affirmed my talent. He said that he wouldn't investigate this more because Ben and Claire were also talented artists who made one bad lapse in judgment. And as a clear-sighted investor, he would keep facilitating young talented creators. He didn't mention anything about Ashley's fault, but then this was expected, as she was his daughter. On the way back home, I received a video message from Claire. Contrary to the complicated situation here, Claire and Ben were enjoying a trip on a remote island. Through all this mess, they'd found love, and I was so happy for them both. I did always say that given time, they'd make the perfect couple. Seeing how happy they were reminded me of my relationship with Noah. We loved each other, but couldn't be free to show it like they do. I avoided to face him, as technically, he was still engaged to Ashley, and the last thing I wanted was to be a wrecker. Then one evening, Ashley messaged me saying, I'm at Terrace Cafe. I have something to say to you. Don't keep me waiting. Ugh, what could she possibly want to say to me? I was so curious, though. So, I went to meet her. I arrived to find her and Noah sitting at a table and chatting to each other. I was kind of worried, and my legs seemed to be stuck to the ground. I didn't dare to walk toward them. She called me out to let me see how they looked good together, didn't she? I was about to leave, but at that point, Noah saw me and he immediately came toward me and led me to the seat. Ashley said to me, You see, we are back together. I should know how ridiculous she was before agreeing to come. Now I stuck myself in this humiliating situation. Suddenly, Ashley laughed out loud and said, Just kidding, don't be so serious. Look, I'm sorry. I behaved badly and disappointed my father. So I've decided that you can have Noah. Then she smiled, But don't expect me to wish you happiness or anything. To my surprise, Noah turned me around to face him and said, We are no longer engaged. Now I'm officially yours, Sarah, if you let me. I almost cried happy tears when Noah asked me, and I never thought that I finally could say yes to him right in front of my used-to-be enemy. 3 months later, everything returned to some sort of normal. Everyone in the company knew that Noah and I were dating, and they all were happy for us. I spent most of my time sculpting, and it was great to follow my passion. As for Ashley, news is she's doing a master's course in England. And as for Claire and Ben, well, their love continued to blossom so fast that after just months of being together, they announced their wedding. Noah came with me to the ceremony, but as soon as we got there, he had to rush off to solve some issues at the company. I was kind of disappointed, but I tried not to show it, as it was my best friend's wedding, and I was so happy for them both.
Then Claire threw the bouquet, and as the belief goes, I wanted to be the one to catch it and marry next. We were all ready to leap for it, but then Claire turned back and walked away. We were so confused. What was she doing? Then she walked towards someone. It was Noah.
Noah? He was back from work?
She gave him the bouquet, and he immediately ran toward me. And to my surprise, he got down on one knee, handed me the bouquet, pulled out this amazing diamond ring, and said,
Sarah, I don't want to lose any more time due to my dumb mistakes. I want to protect you and spend my life with you. So what do you think? Will you marry me?
I couldn't believe my eyes. Noah had this whole thing planned. It was so romantic. I blushed and obviously said yes. Then to cheering and applause, we kissed. Now I'm engaged to the man of my dreams, and hopefully no more obstacles will get in the way of our love. But if they do, well then I say bring them on, as love conquers all.